It's the Line Makers on Sporting News.
Welcome to the Line Makers on Sporting News. I'm Micah Roberts. Joining me is Rick Heron. We've got a Friday night Battle of LA going with the Clippers and the Lakers. And even though we're seeing some momentum gain with the Clippers, we got Laker jerseys and all this other stuff going around, it's still a Laker town, isn't it?
It's still a Laker town. There's no doubt about it. I mean, the crowd will be a little bit in favor of the Clippers, but you know, they're still Laker fans. Let's face it. Now, you know, and you know, the Lakers have struggled so badly, the Clippers have been so tremendous, that more of them, I think, are changing over to being Clipper fans. When you go 16-0 in the month of December, that's pretty strong.
That was impressive. But to note, you also have to note there, the Clippers, out of those all those wins that they had consecutively, I think they only beat four teams with winning records. So, I mean, they've been playing well, but let's see how they do against the Lakers here. And it's not exactly, well, they're a losing team actually right now.
Yeah, they are right now, tonight, as we speak. Yeah, but the, you know, the Clippers did beat teams by 12 or more in 11 of those games in that winning streak. So they were tremendously impressive. You know, you just have to wonder, Micah, with the Lakers that you know, are they going to turn this around? You've heard the Charles Barkley comments. They're old, slow, and unathletic. You heard Magic Johnson, of all people, come out and say that the Clippers are now showtime.
Yeah.
And then finally you got Kobe's comments where he called them an old damn team.
They are, and they've shown that. And the big difference I see between not just the age is you don't see any bench support with the Lakers, and you see all kinds of it. They've got on the Clippers seven guys that have averaged 9 points or higher. You've got Lamar Odom playing excited, and he's not one of those seven guys. And then, just thinking about the future with the playoffs coming, being able to get Chauncey Billups back,
Big addition. You're
going to be able to get Grant Hill back. He hasn't even played yet. So you're looking at a team that I think is extremely dangerous going down the stretch. And then, of course, Chris Paul, we kind of take him for granted because he just does everything well consistently on a nightly basis. But that guy is one heck of a player. So I see the books saw this week the same thing. They dropped the Clippers from 12-1 down to 7-1 to win the NBA championship. That's tied for the third choice. I don't know about here. I mean, what are we looking Friday night? 4.5?
Five, my guess. But that, again, shows that there's still, even with the odds makers, there's still
a
respect for the Lakers. And I do think you'll see the Lakers turn around. Their offense flows a lot more efficiently with Nash. I think Friday night's a big game. It's a statement game for the Lakers. I'd expect them to play well.
And this is a time of year when everybody gets excited for the NBA. Regular season's winding down, finished in the NFL. We get NBA coming back. Go time in the NBA battle for Los Angeles. Thanks for joining us.